we got here? Hey, buddy. Hey. Oh, it's a thorn bush, guys. I'm sorry. These thorns are a little bit painful while I do this, but hey. Hey, Mr. Tortoise. Hi. Should we do tortoise cam? Hi, buddy. I'm sorry to bug you. I didn't mean to scare you. You just chilling? Is it a tortoise? I can't see. I guess from the side, yeah, it looks like a $12. Turtle, I'm not sure. Don't be afraid, buddy. Don't be afraid. Ow. Boy, look where I am. This is kind of a tight squeeze. I couldn't go in there any further, so sorry, folks. I tried. I tried to get Mr. Tortoise. Maybe we'll find some more animals.
Microphone check, 1, 2.
I'm really hoping the microphone works, but although there is no wind, folks, today, no wind whatsoever. But while we're waiting for an okay to camp at a brand new spot so that I could do something very special with you folks today, night fishing at the ranch. You heard me, folks. I said it. Night fishing at the ranch. We've never done this before. Look at this. Look at this. This is the size. I picked up another one the other day that was over here. And see, I don't mind being a good steward for the earth and cleaning up messes and stuff. Do the best we can, you know? See, don't leave your garbage behind. Especially when it's from these bad people here. This is horrible. See, this is the left Twix. See, people lose their left sock all the time. Now you know where your left Twix went. Turkey tail mushrooms. As you can see them, these are called bracket fungus right here. See, it's bracket fungus right there. And I don't know if that's a yellow ganoderma or not. It's got a really defined margin, so I think these are yellow ganoderma. But these are definitely worth taking. These are a little bit rotten, so I'm not going to bother with those. But they grow on the tree like this. You see, they grow off of this. That's a living one, ganoderma. Ganoderma because it has a, usually has a varnishy top. This is white or yellow ganoderma. And they also have turkey tail out here, which look like exactly like a turkey tail. But I just came to see because I thought I saw some turkey tail, but I didn't. What's this right here? Oops, thorns in the foot. See right here, watch out for snakes in there. See right there, that's some good fresh ganodermas right there. Yellow ganoderma. These are really good for the liver. These are dry. These are good. I'm gonna take some of these home. And also this is another medicine right here, this milk thistle. It's very good for you.
Anyway. You checked Google, is the McDonald's over here?
I don't know if that navigator is right, Magoo.
It said Burger King, not McDonald's.
Oh, see, now I don't really want Burger King.
Well, then let's go to Arby's.
Bad news, apparently there's some folks, they're having some turkey hunters here on the, you know, for, because they have hunters that come out here and stuff and do some turkey hunting for food and everything and whatever. But it looks like we won't be able to camp on that one spot on the river today. We might not even be able to fish. Now, I know there's some other water holes around here that have some fish in them, and we might be able to pull some of those fish out just for fun. So we're still waiting to see what the final answer is on this. Stay tuned, folks. Johnny Appleseed. Those are thistle seeds. I'll show you what I mean. It's like dandelions. See? Isn't that pretty? Kind of remind me of like a winter dog's fur. You like winter dogs? See how they open? The bulb. Ooh, pardon me. The bulb here, this bulb, opens. And then all of that flower right there, that blue, ow, God damn. All that blue flower, look at that. Isn't that color? Isn't that pretty? Look at that color, look. It's so violet. Here's one here, look at that. Look. And see how they start those little bulbs like that? Milk thistle. Look, get you a better view of that. And so right here, they all come out of that. Look. Right there, and all of this right here is actually excellent tinder. Look. All that is excellent tinder for making fires. So what we'll do is we don't need it because I have plenty of tinder. I don't want to have to kill any seeds, let them all grow. So I'm gonna help them distribute. And they just fly around, and I just did a little Johnny apple seeding. Gotta love that. Look at that little one. Pretty. Kind of gives you like color ideas for your fabric or something. Well, this might just be a nature walk today, folks. There might not be any fishing at all, so unfortunately. But, oh God, there's thorns or something. A pretty plant, but it's got some thorns here. Johnny Appleseed, folks, Johnny Appleseed. Spread the seed, spread some love. I have looked everywhere to find out what kind of bird that is, and I can't find out. And I don't know where it just went. Usually he'll make a circle back, but they do the tops of the, there it goes. They do the tops of the trees looking for squirrels. They're squirrel eaters. He's coming back this way. I used to think it was like a kingfisher or something, you know, like a seabird, but look at the way it flies. It's some kind of kite, I think. I don't know. I've never seen the tail like that or anything other. It kind of has a fish tail. It's a fork tail, like a Bermuda. What do they call that? The fork tail something. Oh boy, I have to do my bird research. You know, this digital dementia's got me. I've forgotten all of my bird names, but I have a bird brain now. But yeah, there's a bird in Bermuda. The state bird is the tail. You'll see words come across the screen when I do this. Anyway, there it goes. He's still hunting the trees. Probably gonna stay away from me right now, but that's okay.
See, I'm gonna try to blow up the image. I mean, the window's dirty. There's an eagle, brown eagle. Walking across here. We turned off the car so he doesn't notice us over here. I could see he's not looking at me, so I know that doesn't notice we're here. He might walk over here. He's just walking like a penguin. What kind of strange eagle is this? He's just walking around like a duck. See him? What a strange little bugger. He's in the grass right there, like a partridge. Oh, he just picked something up off the ground, a dead something or other. I see it like shaking in his mouth.
Can you turn the key on so I can...
He's got a dead mouse in his hand. He's got a dead animal. No, he's eating it. What is that? What's he got? I can't tell. It's some kind of... He's chowing like a champ. See him now?
Yeah.
Can you see what he's eating? Is it a snake? Oh, folks, I don't know if you're getting a view of that thing. I think you might be. I'm trying to keep my head still.
I got footage if you don't.
Okay. I'm gonna head outside here so you get an outside view. He just heard me moving. He's eating. I don't want to disturb, but we have to go. Oh, he's got a, looks like a baby skunk or something. I can't really tell. Baby squirrel. Oh, that's what that is. It's a squirrel. Well, we're gonna have to make him fly now, I'm sadly to say. He's taking his squirrel and he's going. Oh, he dropped the squirrel. He dropped it. He's like, oh, you sons of bees. That's okay. Well, let me see what he's eating. I'll go find it right here. I think he dropped it right here. Let me see if he fights me over his squirrel. I want to see what he's eating. It was right here. He dropped it. There it is. Oh, it's the leg of a pig. It's the leg of a pig, dude. A very small pig and a very fresh kill. I don't want to touch it. Well, yeah, I am going. He's going to come get it, but I just want to look at it.
show the audience at home here. See, folks? Oh no, it's a skunk. It's the foot of a skunk. See, folks? That's the leg of a skunk, and it's fresh. You could eat that if you needed to. Go ahead, Eagle, enjoy your meal. See you at the campsite. We just got it okay to go spend the night at a lake where we're gonna be camping and night fishing. I'm gonna say it, I shit you not, and there's a gator right here about 4 feet long, right in front of me. If you just saw him, he just kind of scooted. But we are gonna be camping right here, folks. I want you to take a look at this. This is our home tonight. Look at that gator. He's about 5 feet long, Magoo. Yeah, he's a healthy gator. That means there's good fish in there. There's a fish right here. There's a bass right here, Magoo, at the shoreline, looking at me. See, folks?
He'll be more interested in that bass than he is us.
Wow. Folks, how's the theme from the Ponderosa go? The what is that show? Yes. Thank you. Sometimes, you know, prayers or whatever you want to call them are answered. This is 25 feet deep here, apparently. It was all shell dug out, and this is stocked. We're going to be catching, hopefully, some bass and some, maybe not the alligator there, but we'll be catching some African cichlid, other species too. Some catfish should be in here. Should have a whole smorgasbord. Let's get ourselves set up at the tent, and we'll be fishing here all night long, folks. Look at this. They were turkey hunting back there, so we had to be moved to a different spot here. And look what we ended up getting. I mean, I don't think you can ask for much more, folks. I don't think you can ask for much more. Here's a young oak tree. Nice young oak. Wood's gonna be an issue, but it's not cold out, so we're not too worried about fires, just for cooking. There's a stand of trees out there where we could go for wood, but we're gonna be camping right here so that we have this nice vista all night long of the lake, which is just gonna be great under a full moon, if we get a full moon with all this stuff they're spraying on us. But anyway, folks, let me get set up and we'll get out there and fish and have some fun. We have two gators here. If you can see right here on the shoreline, this one right there. Right there. Why are you going swimming? You going swimming? I won't molest the gators. You know, there are signs in Florida that say, please do not molest the gators. And I laugh to myself. I say, now wait a minute. Do not molest the gators. Do not molest what? Those guys could do some damage. They're right at that size where they're a little bit unhealthy to play with. Now, see, look, if I stepped right here, that's all water. I would go down probably a few feet. There's an overhang here, so I gotta be careful. But yeah, gators, we have gators. It's gonna be great. Loving this. Miss Magoo is blowing up the air mattresses. We are gonna go fish this a little bit. I'm gonna start casting from back here. This way I don't spook anything that's right there at the shoreline. If there is, and then we'll find out shortly if there is. There's a fish already. First fish of the day, folks. First cast, first fish. Holy cow, that's what you call fishing. Oops, he's not even hooked. It went all the way through and kind of came out the other side and whatnot. And get that out of there. Okay, all right. Here we go, folks. We're off the skunk. First cast, first cast.
Wow.
A little largemouth bass. Just get you back in the water there and try that again. Wow, that was pretty quick. I seem to like this fishing spot. Now, that is going to bring a friend around here. And we can say that this alligator is a little bit bigger than our other friend, Fred. From Al, the other episode, or in the opener, Fred's not quite as big as these alligators, are a little bit bigger, and any kind of fish will definitely get their attention, so you gotta be careful. Let's see if we can't do that again. Let's take a little hobble around this little stream here. This lake, I mean, lake stream. Jeez, there's no stream here, there's a lake. Now, I'm probably gonna be putting some weight on this, being that it's so deep and the water's really milky. As you saw, that bass was really light colored. And the light colored bass indicates, you know, lighter colored water. And you can see that this water is very, almost sandy colored from the fact that it's a lot of calcium out here and a lot of shell. And the shell is also is a lot of calcium. It doesn't hurt the fish, just the water pH is a little bit less acidic out here, which is really good for the fish, as a matter of fact. Obviously, it's like reservoir quality water out here. It comes from an underwater well. This comes from the water table, this water. This isn't pumped from a stream. This isn't coming from somebody's tanks. This is water coming from the earth through the shell. God, that jumped out of nowhere. Coming through the shell, whoa, it's really deep grass, and cleaning it. It's filtered, pure, clean water from the earth, and filtered by the earth, as a matter of fact. The other side's got all the cattails where all the fish are probably going to be hanging up. So we're just going to try to fish a little bit while we're setting up camp here. We still got a little bit of sunlight left, and we're going to fish this inside cove while we can right here just to investigate the area. We don't have much time. We only have overnight. So I'm going to do my best to fish this thing as hard as possible. And anyway, let's see what we can find here. Let's get this side over here. So yeah, let's work. See right there, this little cut? Fish right across the front of this. Right here, there should be somebody living in this. Right in this little cut right here. Let's see, you should have somebody strike right now. Nothing? Nobody? Anybody home? Anybody's home? Boy, make a liar out of me. Okay. Sink right down in there. I found a couple worm hooks in the car, which I'm really excited about. These wide gap worm hooks. And if anybody wants to know, I'm using like a number 8, I believe, or a number 7. Nice, a super wide gap. And usually I use a thinner wire hook. I like a thinner wire. I don't like thick wire hooks because, first of all, they're very visible. Gators right there. They're very visible and they're very, tough sometimes to get a hook set because they're a little bit too heavy. They don't penetrate as easily as a fine wire hook. So one gator's out there, the other one's right there, and I saw bubbles right there. It could be anything. It could be anything. It could be a turtle. Could have just been gas. And, the nitrogen cycle creates nitrous oxide that gets released from the earth. And so you have nitrogen gas that actually releases itself from the earth. That's when you see bubbles coming up from the bottom. It's not Nessie, it's nitrogen. Yeah, I'm gonna have to put a weight on this to let this sink down to the bottom, otherwise I just have to wait. You could just wait. I mean, it's probably gonna sink about 1 foot per second. So if you count down 10 seconds, it's about 10 feet. Approximately, it depends. You could count down on the shoreline and see how it works. You can also put it in a bucket and measure, put a ruler on the side of the bucket and actually measure the depth it takes by the time it takes to sink. And you'll find out what the sinking rate of your lure is, and therefore you can actually figure that out. You know what I mean? So I'm letting it get a little bit deeper now and fall down into that. It's about 25 feet, he said here, in the summer, deep in the middle of summer. Right now it's probably about 18 feet, I think. I'm not sure, but I could plumb it. What I'm going to be doing is putting the GoPro down there as well, and we'll see what kind of critters are living in there. There's a bass bed right there, and I see a lot of little fish swimming around it, which is a really good sign. I probably wouldn't want to stand in that water. It looks like it might take me right down. I want to fish that right there. This inside cove, that's not where I wanted it, but that's okay. I'll take it. I'll take it. I don't know if that's the beach over there. I don't know anything about this waterway at all. It's all a mystery for me right now. But at least we were off the skunk. First fish, first cast. Something should pop that if it lives over there, that's for sure, right? You think? What do you think? Try fishing that whole edge right there from here. Get the wind up my back so my cast can make it. I'm trying to sink off the edge here. Oops, that's wet. Yes, that's wet. Okay. It was almost a no-go for fishing, and we were graced with this kind of a thing. So it went from almost no fishing at all to holy cow. What? I think that's the other one just swam out there. You sure? At least we have good company. We have good company. Well, yeah, put it out there and see what's out there. On my way back, go help Magoo set up. I kind of abandoned her. You go take a few casts. Sorry, Magoo. I would go swimming. But that's probably one of the worst ideas. Now, seeing as this water is fairly foggy, like it's got like kind of a turbidity to it where there's a lot of particulate in it, my options probably would be switch to a shiner, something spinning, like a spinner, something shiny. And what that'll do is give, when that gets like that, you have to re-hook it because it swims funny and the fish won't eat it. It'll actually spook fish away, scare them right off the beach. So that's why I use crazy glue, but I don't have that much and I have to repair a frog. So I have to do some surgery on a frog. And I thought it was a gator. He'd eat that, guaranteed. Gators would just chomp that thing. Something tells me, because this is a closed waterway, that anything in here is prey. That there's really no safe haven. Open waterways, the fish have much more feed. And here the competition level gets higher. Even though it's large, the fish can't even see the other side. It still creates a level of competition because there's a limit to the amount of food in there. And that in itself will have the fish in a tizzy. Anyway. Happy we got one to start. We're gonna work our way around to the other side, but at least right here we know somebody lives right here. Oh, they're actually, you're right, Magoo, there's three. One, two, three. Three gators. We're gonna walk this entire pond here. And as the sun goes down, these fish will come closer to the surface. They don't have eyelids, so they can't really spend their days up on the surface getting blinded by the light. Wrapped up like a taco, burrito in the night. How you doing? You need help? With anything? You're eating watermelon? I don't think you need help with that. But I will help you anyway. I feel like you need help with that watermelon. So I'm on my way. After I catch this. Huh? What you want? What? I think I caught the only fish here. I got them. I got the biggest and the best. I can hear Steven up there. Thank you, Steven, so much. Holy cow, this is awesome. Even if that was the only fish I catch all night, that was just worth it. Gator, a gator. No, it's not a chia pet, it's a gator. Have you ever camped next to gators, folks? It's not bad. When you're a Floridian, you live with gators. It's our local college, is, you know, we have a gator fetish at the college thing level. So they call themselves the Florida Gators. Original, right? Isn't that the most original name you ever heard for a team? Florida Gators. Some teams are called the Pelicans. Some are called Tarpons. Some are called Marlins. Some are called Pirates. So original that they have to patent these things because they don't want anybody to steal their ideas. One of the funny things about when I first came to Florida was when I tried to find Bay Street, and there were 15 of them, at least, maybe more than 15 Bay Streets, and I'm confused. I'm trying to say, well, wait a minute, they're all lined up next to each other, one after another, Bay Street, Bay Street, Bay Street, and I didn't understand this. I said, well, couldn't they have named it a different name? Did they all have to be named Bay Street? And so what I found out was it wasn't only those 12 Bay Streets, but on the other side of the canal was another 12 Bay Streets, the opposite ends of those first Bay Streets. So altogether, it's 24 Bay Streets in a small community. As you can see, my confusion and my love for Floridian zoning became a legend in its time. All right, let's get the camera. This is all the wood that we got. This is at this spot right over here. That's the only dead tree I could find right now, so I'm trying to make my way through here without getting myself jacked up, but looks like I'll be able to knock some of these branches off of this tree. No problem at all. Try to get them out there now. Move this. Look at that beautiful air plant. Isn't that cool? It's amazing, isn't it? It's a rabbit.
It's the Easter bunny.
It's the Easter bunny.
It's the Easter bunny.
Folks, look.
It's Peter Cotton.
It's the Easter bunny. Yeah. Let's see if I can sneak up on him. Look at me sneaking up on a gator. All right, I just went to the local Walmart and it was the biggest freak show ever with single lines and weird, ordered and societal manifestations and all that other good stuff. And so we ended up having to go to somewhere else to get bread. But I'm telling you, folks, your best bet is to go hide in the woods. All right, let's get the camp set up and we'll see you out here in a minute, Mr. Gator and Mrs., and we'll hang out with some stuff. Firewood for the night. And get some rope here and get some wood. Should be okay. Gotta watch out, I don't step on anything alive. Be careful when you're pushing and pulling trees. You know what? First of all, you don't want them to fall on top of you. Second of all, if you get on the right angle of it, you can take the whole branch down and get yourself a nice piece of wood. Just don't stand out on a broken limb and fall off, you know what I mean? That's not the good thing to do. Get myself a better position here. These aren't tree climbing shoes. These are Crocs with... No, this is pretty tough wood. Go to the end and see. This should come off pretty easy. All right. Good stuff, good stuff. So, when you don't have a chainsaw, you gotta rely on good old muscle. And usually it works pretty well. So we'll be doing this. Let me just get some more lumber. We'll get the campsite set up. And Get a few more branches off this thing and see what we can't do here about getting some dinner in us. Be back in a second.
It's the backbone of a snake. That's the bones, the skeleton of a snake. It's the backbone. This is a, obviously probably the head end right there. I'm not sure. No, that's the tail. That's a rattlesnake. That's a rattlesnake tail. That's the head. Yeah, because these are the rib cage. That's the ribs right there. And that's the tail. And you can see that it's got kind of a nubbin right there for the rattle.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, rattlesnake.
Oh, that's lovely.
Someone probably killed him here camping or something or whatever. Gator was right here at the edge hunting me. Well, the moon's coming out and we're still here. I don't know if you can see even that what I'm doing. I don't even know if you can see me fishing here. But if you can, we're gonna try to catch a bass for the night hit closes down, and I will be fishing with bait. We're gonna be throwing out there some chicken gizzard stuff and seeing if we can't get a monster catfish or something. You know, so we'll see what happens here. I'll let that sink a little bit. The fish should be up a little bit higher in the water column now due to the fact that there's no more sun. I'm just ticking that lure, moving it along.
When you cast that?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Seem like there's too much out there. Probably out deeper to the middle there. I'll let that go all the way down. I'm seeing the gators right there. I don't see the other one. See, at night with the bass, or at least, you know, in the mornings, what they'll do is they'll come up along the edges to feed along the shorelines out of the depths. So that's when you're usually going to be doing better. When there's a little bit of cloud or when it's evening or morning, you'll get more bass on the shoreline. There we go. Got him. All right. That's a the littlest bass. Hello. Oh, good to see you. Welcome to YouTube. Hello. Look at that little bass. Isn't that pretty? Beautiful little guy. He's a little largemouth bass. Tiny little largemouth. I think you could see him. I'm pretty sure you can. As the owls are hooting. No, as the dogs. Go ahead, buddy. Enlarge. Enlarge yourself. Okay. It sounded huge. Huge. That fish was definitely, it was definitely a trophy before I caught it. It was the biggest fish in this waterway before I actually caught it. But once I got it up to the shoreline, it shrunk. That's it. They get close to the shore, they just shrink. That again. Try the same spot right on the inner edge right here.
was cool. We're starting to run out of light right now. But take a few more casts. Plus, I gotta get this. There's a little bit of a loop in my line. There it is. Got rid of it. All right. Yeah, there's an edge right here. There's probably about 3 foot overhang or 2 foot overhang right under the edge. So I'd have to watch out. I could just get my foot goes down in there and then somebody wants to eat it. So, and of course, when you see the reeds moving and there's no wind blowing, then that means somebody's underneath there, kind of sneaking around. Is it? Coffee time, folks. We forgot the coffee pot, so we have to heat the water in bowls. And then we're going to put it in the cups and see how we can manage this one. I'm going to have it in the cup, but I don't know.